Hey, what is up, everyone? It's Rich. As I was starting this video, I'm laughing because I had clicked on another video that I had on YouTube accidentally, and the other day I was cleaning out my hard drive. I'll get into this book in just a second. I won't ramble long. I was deleting old videos that I had recorded, and like every video is like, hey. I need a new intro, or would the videos not be the same without it? Anyway, poor cunt. You say it out loud, it actually sounds even dirtier than just the words pork hunt. Pork hunt. He requested Black Axe, and I really appreciated all the information that he put on the video that I posted today. Motormouth? Pretty sure that was what it was called. I'd never heard of Black Axe. It sounded like vaguely familiar. And I'm really having a lot of fun looking at these Marvel UK books. In fact, I actually did three videos today of the Marvel UK stuff. So I have other ones in the can, but I don't know. This was like, I was like Black Axe. I'm super into Dungeons and Dragons right now. I know this won't be that kind of thing, but Black Axe sounded badass. And so this is interesting. I don't know if John Romita Jr. did the interiors, but he did this cover. We'll look at it in full screen mode with the black background. But it's a nice John Romita Jr. piece. This is from 1992. So it's a super, super old school one. It's interesting that he did it for Marvel UK. I don't know specifically if Marvel UK, I mean, I know that John Romita Jr. is a New York guy, nearly sure. So clearly they don't only hire UK artists, but I kind of think the interiors may not be Romita Jr. Could be wrong though, I don't know. But he said he was hoping that I was going to do this book. So Pork Hunt, this is for you. I'm a dork. All right, we want to go in order. It's kind of fun. Okay, so this is definitely not John Romita Jr. We've got some classic Marvel UK green. No, I'm kidding. Oh, that you might you didn't you don't know that joke yet. That's in video number three. I can't reference the other videos. Oh my God, I'm cock blocked from the beginning of this video. Interesting. This almost it reminds me a little bit of like Aaron Weisenfeld. This person probably has a little bit of a Barry Windsor Smith influence. I'll try to reverse engineer who it is, although probably the next page will say. But that's definitely a little Windsor Smith-ish. You know, Barry was really big at this point. You figure Weapon X had just come out, and I mean that was pretty like landmark comic. And I mean, who wouldn't be influenced by Barry Windsor Smith and what the studio guys did? You have to be a damn lunatic, some sort of savage. So, but this doesn't look derivative. In fact, this doesn't look anything like Barry Windsor Smith. All right, what do we got? Who is this? Edmund Perryman and Rod Ramos. So I know Rod Ramos's name. I do not know Edmund Perryman at all. And Black Axe was created by Michael Bennett and Edmund Perryman. So this is an original thing. We've got editor in chief Paul Neary. And letters, colors, Steve Whitaker. And this is 1993, April of 1993. Easter was in the air when this book was drawn. Now this almost looks like a two-page spread, but maybe not. So the black looks like it's on the paper. This is I like the colors on this. It's a little different. I have some vague memories of collecting around this time, and it was interesting to watch the effect that Image Comics had on a fan's perception of what comics should look like. And there was definitely a point where Marvel started to look a little dated. And this is coming from a new collector. I was no expert. I wasn't a professional. I was just a normal fan going to the store. You never like when I first started collecting comics, I would have never in a million years thought that I was going to work in comics. It wasn't a goal, wasn't anything. I was a professional musician, and I was rocking the United States with my grunge, weird rock, whatever we want to call it. It was a little pre-grunge, but proto-grunge. But yeah, I mean, I just got into comics as a hobby, and then I'd always been able to draw pretty well, and I saw it and I was like, I can do this shit. Come on, sign me up. How much are these guys making? 40 million a year? I want that because I'm making 0.0 a year. So this is interesting. It's a little hard for me to tell what this is. It looks like it's some sort of blade, but it's a unique design. I actually like all the edges and stuff on it. Like, it looks pretty cool. Now, they may have established it in the previous page, and I just was a dumbass rambling and didn't see it. Yeah, Sky stuff is interesting. It's... I don't know who this imp would be. Like, it's, you know... Whenever you see someone's work and you're not familiar with it, you kind of... what's that guy's name? David Lapham? Is it a little Lapham-ish? You always try to ground it in something that you're familiar with. It's in an... I don't know. Who knows? Maybe it's John Romita Jr. and I'm just like, loose. Wow, okay, this guy's storytelling is actually very cool. This is a nice page. Let's zoom out. I apologize. I tend to zoom in, but a full page read is very, very important to me, to be clear. Like, it's more... I feel like for people watching this on small devices, this might not read well, so I tend to do that. This is really cool. I like this a lot. And the colors... this is looking really good. His characters aren't as strong as his stuff, and I don't mean that in a disrespectful way, but I mean, some artists are better at doing gear and tech stuff, and some artists are better at characters and, you know, neglect the tech stuff, and, you know, some bridge the two, but... we'll see. It's interesting. Definitely getting like it's like, yeah, his characters are interesting. I could see reading this that you would really settle into this kind of weird world that he's portraying. I always say, when I first started collecting, when I would get runs of books, as long as the art kind of matched the story, I was not as particular as you might imagine about the art in general. And what was more difficult is, like, say if I read like 6 or 7 books of this artist, and he's doing a really good job, to be clear. But if it switched, and it even switched to someone that was better, but all of a sudden now all the characters look different, that's harder to wrap your brain around than, you know, someone that has a unique style or, you know, isn't a beloved, like, greatest artist ever kind of vibe. It's really interesting. I don't know if it's because the characters are black, but it is reminding me of Martha Washington Goes to War, which I think was coming out around this time. I collected that. That was Frank Miller and Dave Gibbons, I think. It's been a million years since I've seen the book, but I think that's who it was. I could be wrong. Now I'm embarrassing myself. Like, it was Alan Moore and, you know. Oh, wow, look at this. I've seen so many comics between now and 1995. Forgive me. All right. This is cool. I'm always like I put so much detail, not always, but sometimes. I'm always amazed that artists can leave things alone. I'm not a big rendering guy. It sounds weird because my stuff will have a lot of lines, but I'm trying to build up the confidence to be able to render like in the right places. This is really cool. Really cool design. I love the these thick kind of old school sci-fi shapes. This is nice too. Wow. Yeah, this is a fun book. Good job, poor cunt. I switched the emphasis on that. Did you notice that? I took it there. All right, Death's Head, my man, with the super designed costume. I think that's a joke from another video too. But Death's Head has got like the busiest, like, surprised he doesn't have more stuff on his body, but he's a very wild design. I remember even thinking that when I first started collecting. I was like, I like this character, but it's a very, like, his colors are trippy. You know, like, he's got like horns on his face and a skull and wires for a neck. This is pretty cool. I'd be curious how many people ever collected or read this. Probably the only ones that are watching the video. Everyone else is like, what is Rich posting all these weird comics? Because, I mean, I haven't heard of this. So, I'm just one of you. Pork Hunt is leading the way today. And And thanks for asking about Blaster Kid Pork. Like I said in my other reply to you, I'm gonna be making announcements starting tomorrow, and then just kind of rolling out more information. But I'm gonna get the logo finalized in like Illustrator. I'm gonna get the Indiegogo page. These are like my short list of things that I want to do and as quickly as possible. I want to get the pre-launch page back up. I just can't remember. I believe I can just keep adding to it. Like I can put up, you know, 4 or 5 images of what I've got going on right now, show people, and then I can add to it over the next few weeks. I want to try to launch the book in the next 4 weeks, I think. I have to talk to some people and get some help on it. So, that's what's going on. But it is moving forward at a more intense pace now. I can feel the intensity. This whole week was palpable. Oh my god, this week was so stressful. Let me just get this off my chest. So the piece that I posted, it doesn't read that well online. It's much more impressive in person, but it's a gigantic headshot of this bad guy. He's like a tertiary bad guy, but it's a really big drawing, and it doesn't read like as big as it is when you look at it online. It's like a full 11 by 17, basically, of a guy's head and a little bit of his torso. But the probably visually the thing that would look the hardest to do on it would be his face, like all the rendering. But that was actually fun and easy. What was hard is doing his body. Oh my god, because it was scrunched in, and I was like, oh my god, do not mess this thing up on like his freaking jacket. So anyway, but it was a super stressful week, and then I was stressed out about some other stuff too. But it's all over now. We can enjoy Black Axe. I kind of like this page. This is cool. I'm a big fan of like stairs and stuff like that in comics. I always think it's fun. Oh wow, this is cool. There was a book by Dave Johnson that I was a big fan of, and I don't know why. This art doesn't really look that much like it, but this page immediately brought it to mind. There was a game, it was called Chain Gang War, and it came out around this time. It was, I think, an Ultraverse book, or no, I think it was DC. It was cool, though, but it was, I don't know why, but this gave me those vibes. It's like kind of graphic, strong shapes. Should really do a video on Chain Gang War, because I've never actually even done a video on Dave Johnson's art. Yeah, that was my first introduction to Dave Johnson's stuff. Nearly sure. Thought he was really good. All right. Oh, so this thing is big. I didn't realize how big it was. Is there a little bit of Walter Simonson in this guy's stuff? Is that what I'm seeing? Pork Hunt. What about Cockrum? Is there a Cockrum in this? That's Barry Windsor Smith. Come on. So it is. It's like it's some David Lapham and Barry Windsor Smith, right? And then no Cockrum. But maybe some Walter Simonson and My Chemical Romance, right? Now people are getting mad. Stop, Eric. Pretty sure that's one of the characters from the Black Parade video. All right, what do we got? I like this. That's really cool. Let's soak this in for a moment, shall we? Yeah, that's fun. It's an interesting shot. I like how he leveled. Like I like that there's like a level, and then it goes down a little bit, and you've got this plank that goes up, and then it goes down a little bit, and this. It's really, really nicely done. This is great. I love this little area over here. It's very fun. Like the nook with this sort of, I don't, you know, like looks like a, you could, what do they call it on Star Trek when they would sort of phase in and phase out? I don't know. And then this is all pretty cool too. Oh, I thought it said hepatitis. Hepatitis 4, heal me. This is really interesting. Hey, look, it's looks like early J. Scott Campbell when he would draw Chang, who was his Grunge's dad. That's cool. I like that a lot. Damn, that's a nice drawing. This guy right here. Ooh, that's really cool. His face is super creepy. Why do I like the dark stuff so much? What's wrong with me? No, I like fun stuff too. I was recommending Danger Girl to someone today. It's good storytelling because Campbell did a real good job on that. This is nice. It's possible that there is some John Romita Jr. in this guy's stuff too. And who knows? Maybe I'm wrong. Maybe he influenced all of them. I don't even know. It's funny because if this is a Barry Windsor Smith influence, you could see the parallels between what Jim took from Barry Windsor Smith, because there's a little sense of Jim Lee in this too. It's very, very subtle, but and this even too looks a little bit like some of Jim Lee's like side characters, not a hero archetype, but Jim's got a couple of like he's got the thug face that he does. He's got this kind of guy face that's sort of like the mysterious, smarter guy, and probably some others if I could think about it for a second, but we're focused on this. Stay on plot, Rich. This is pretty cool. Psychedelic. Oh man, I love stuff like this. That's really, really cool. I did this lighting so much in Crystal Planet. I'd always have the arc light coming down. That's funny. It's a nice, it works well because it always leads the eye. Like, you can use this in real strong shape to pull you right in here. This is actually a very nice laid out sequence if you want to know the truth, because he pulls you like this, and this really frames these characters great. And then he puts you right into this. This guy's arm takes you down and towards this panel. And this all reads great. Really, really nicely laid out page. The subtleties of it are easy to sleep on if you're a sleeper. All right. My goal now is to, I was going to say a joke, but this is really interesting. That's a very wild looking panel, yeah? The egg certificate, let me shut this door. My next door neighbor's dog is he's very vocal. I call him Sir Barks-a-Lot, if you've seen any of my other videos. Oh, you know what? I don't have a picture of Sir Barks-a-Lot, but he'll be the thumbnail for this. a Sir Barks-a-Lot breed. Oh my god. It's like all of my corny jokes are coming together. I like that all the Marvel UK books have the animals reacting to the books. And clickbait titles. It's genius. I hope people don't think I'm serious. It's just poking fun. You know what it is? I'll be honest. Okay, I'm an adult. And I'm not like a kid. I'm an adult. Middle-aged adult. It's weird for me to see grown men make reactions like they're a 14-year-old on TikTok for their YouTube videos. I'm not hating. It's just really, do you need views that bad that you're gonna have the surprised face? I don't know. Like I said, I'm not hating. I'm just saying. It's a difference. It's just pointing out an observation that I find it weird. Like, Rick Beato does it. I love Rick Beato. He's a great man. A music educator. He's doing good work. He even does it. He's in his 60s. He's got, close to 4 million viewers, too. Maybe I should start reacting to my thumbnails. Yeah, so at times I definitely feel like I see a little bit of John Romita Jr. in his stuff. I inked John Romita Jr. on and off for a few months, I'm getting some JRJR vibes. Definitely Barry Windsor Smith. The David Lapham thing is that's a Hail Mary. I'm not that familiar with how David Lapham actually draws, to be honest. I definitely have comics that he's done, but I don't know his work real well. He may not even be a pencil. I could be totally wrong. My apologies if he's not. And then who was the other one? Oh, Walter Simonson. So you tell me if I'm hitting maybe possible influences on this guy, and then if you see anyone else. Well, that was really fun. Thank you, poor cunt. You just made my Friday a little bit better. So, okay. You guys have a great day. Like I said, I've got multiple videos in the can. And if you have more Marvel UK books you'd like to recommend, poor cunt included, please feel free to do it. This is nice. He does some very cool tech. I actually really, really like his designs on this stuff. He's got a very unique voice. It's really good, honestly. Super, like, just feels kind of original to me, honestly. I've seen a lot of tech. I think this guy does some good stuff. So, all right, you guys have a great day. I'm going to get to work, and I will talk to you later. Bye.